Welcome to Responsive Cities, the fourth edition of the Future Cities MOOC series. The previous edition in the Future Cities MOOC series was about smart cities. If you have taken that course, you have learned that smart buildings and smart cities are human-made structures which are increasingly monitored, metered, networked, and controlled in those aspects which are of interest to the owners, builders, managers, and increasingly for the occupants or the citizens. Now you can go one step further and explore the next generation of cities, the responsive cities. Cities become first smart and then responsive. Around 2005, the first smart cities were technology driven and they produced large amounts of data from fixed or centrally controlled sensors. But by now, the citizens and their mobile phones have taken the leading role in direct data generation. The dynamics of life in the city become visible. Through smartphone apps, citizens begin to communicate directly with their city and vice versa. Citizens start to influence infrastructure and governance processes in the city almost in real time. This will differentiate the responsive city from the smart city. To describe the potential of responsive cities, we define the concept of citizen design science, a combination of citizen design, citizen science, and design science. Experts, citizens, and scientists participate in citizen design science. This approach is still in an early stage of development, but with the Responsive Cities Massive Open Online course, you will be ahead in exploring and defining its possibilities. In order to become more livable and resilient, the fast-growing cities south and north of the equator, but also existing cities, will need the collective and individual input of their citizens. Responsive cities are about bringing cities back to their citizens. Responsive cities change the way the technology of a smart city is used. Rather than using data that are centrally collected and stored, you will see platforms on which the citizens place the data and the information they decide to share. With this, your own responsibility becomes a foundation of a responsive city. In the ideal responsive city, citizens can move from complaining to designing. To get a glimpse what this could mean, you will work with our tried and tested interactive online urban design massing and analysis web modeler called Quackit. Through using the Quackit modeler, you can share your findings. You can comment, vote, and make suggestions on the results of others and understand how cities around the world can benefit from big data-informed urban design and its dynamics. An ETH teaching and research team leads you through the exercises. As citizen design scientists, you will begin with urban measurements. You will move on to design and model an urban neighborhood. And you will finally design an app or a process to support the future responsive city governance process. And now we invite you to explore and engage with us in the development of the new generation of cities, the responsive city.